Now this cover, as per B, whatever is covered under C is given as a wider cover. In addition to whatever covered under C, these are the peril which are covered. Earthquake, volcanic eruption and lightning, washing overboard, entry of water, total loss of package. These are the additional cover, four covers which are given under B, over and above what is provided under C. C cover normally chosen for sea transit, mostly for engineering items and iron rods, some open items, all those unpacked items which are stent can be covered and other things can be covered. Widest cover is C. So AC, ICCA gives all risk cover other than the specified exclusion, both the blame collision and general average and salvage charges that we already discussed. Now exclusions. See, principal misconduct of the assured we have already seen. Supposing the insured sends an item which was not declared to the original. Suppose he says that he is sending some machines inside, some parts of the machines inside the packing. He may send something else other than that. He can prepare to claim. Then we will decline as the delay. This is only important class. What is this delay? Even though delay caused by an insured peril. Supposing from Surat, vegetables are sent to Bombay. And there is a violence because of the riot in Vapi. The lorry which is carrying vegetable may not be allowed to go for 3 days. The insured peril may be a riot. And 3 days the lorry is there with vegetable, all the vegetables were found damaged when they reach Bombay. The delay is the cause of vegetables perishing, not the occurrence of insured peril known as riot. The quality of a cargo that is sent in transit has to go in time, otherwise it will suffer by delay. The delay is the reason for the loss of the vessel, though the insured peril operated. The loss due to delay, due to the nature of the goods, is not admitted as claim under cargo. Ordinary wear and tear, crockeries, all these things will have ordinary wear and tear, that we cannot admit. Ordinary leakage and breakage. We know now even tankers leak, certain items are leaking, that is not covered. Loss in weight or loss in volume. What is loss in weight? Supposing I send groundnuts. The groundnuts will weigh 100 kgs per bag. When it descend from Saurashtra, Rajkot, and sent to Bombay, it goes by road. Suppose those items are sent in the vessel and they go to some other country, the weight may be at the final destination lesser than what was sent. The reason may be the groundnuts or the grains which are sent may have the water content. Because of the change in tropical conditions, it may go away from that. Then it gets dried. The weight of those items will wave lesser than what was waved at the place of dispatch. That loss is not payable. Loss in volume. We know the liquid items are sent which are subject to evaporation. Such loss is not paid because they are all normal losses. Now see evaporation of fluid. Bulk oil which are now normally brought to the tanker by pipelines from the point of a loading. Bulk left in pipelines used for loading and discharge, or even left in holds, and loss of moisture from shipment reducing the weight and causing an apparent shortage, breakage during normal handling, are inevitable losses which are not covered under this one. This is inherent nature. Now, bacteria in meat can develop, fish can develop bacteria, fruits can develop bacteria. Plantation combustion can come from soft coal. Fish meal rusting of unprotected. This can lead to losses. They are all inevitable in nature because of them. Then, the rats are vulnerable. Now, financial defaults are involved as assured. Supposing the ship owner has not affected any payment to the authorities, then it is not covered. Suppose the delay may arise. Because you would not have paid the duties for the cargo imported. Customs authorities will take away the cargo. Claim cannot be given. Now, improper packing or inadequate packing or unsuitable packing. Improper packing, they may use cotton bags or gunny bags for sending engineering items. You know, iron items. They may come out and cause it. They may, you know, lift, the people who are handling may throw the bag, it can sustain damage. Or inadequate packing. They may use single gunny bag instead of two gunny bags. When the hook is used, supposing it is rice, it will fall off. Suppose sugar, they will fall off. Suppose wheat flour, they will fall off. Those things are unsuitable packing. Keeping cotton, silk sarees, or silk sarees in the wooden box, hammering the nail, can cause a damage. They are all not covered under cargo policies. Unseaworthiness. As I said, unseaworthiness has to be established by, so the burden of proof is on the cargo. Normally, this is now exposed. SRC is an exclusion that can be opted on additional premium. War and warlike operation perils can also be taken as additional perils. Now, terrorism, we do not cover, but additional premium we can cover. There are important subclasses which we have already seen. Termination of contract of carriage act, insurable interest class, forwarding charges class, constructive total loss, duty of the assured class, fault, negligence, insolvency, financial default of the assured and the servant are not covered. Then, increased value policy. It may be profit, 25% of the value we can increase, or it can be duty which can be added up. Now, these are the important class. Change of voyage class we have already seen. The moment it gets into the mind of the person, as per Marine Act, it is not covered. Under the policy, it can be held covered with notice to the underwriter and with additional premium. And deviation also like that only. But delay, you need to know little. What is delay class? Now, goods are imported from outside to India. Goods arrive Bombay airport, Bombay port. The owner may not pay the duty and take the goods. Damage will occur. Delay is the cause because he has not made the payment because financial default. That delay is not excused. That is within the control of the insured. Supposing tomorrow the authorities, drug authorities, wants all the cargo imported to go to library. They want to find out the nature of the cargo before delivery. Then loss suffer. It may be not within the control of the insured. It is beyond the control of the insured. If loss occurs due to insured peril, claim is admitted. There may be a strike. There may be riot within the port. And that may cause a delay. That is excused because that is not within the control of the duration class we have seen. It commences from the time it leaves and cover is there during the course of transit or transshipment or reshipment. And it continues until, if at all there is any information that they have to stop and allocate to some other purchaser, or distribute to some other dealers, cover ceases. Or it is available till it reaches final destination. Once it reaches final destination, if it is inland transit, 7 days is the time limit. Either you should take the delivery. If it takes delivery by 2nd, it is allowed. If it takes on 7th, it is allowed. If it comes for delivery on 8th, cover is not available if loss occurs. And extension can be sought with an additional premium. In case of a sea transit, 60 days class, it can be extended, that is not necessary. Then comes air transit, 30 days, which can also be extended. Then termination of contract of carriage class, forwarding charges class we have seen, insurable interest class we have seen, duty of the assured class we have seen. And with another small example, let me conclude the subject and types of policies and what is covered under inland transit. All that can be referred by classes only.
Yeah.
See what happens. Now there is a multi-cargo ship. X comes and wants to send cargo. Garlic. Then somebody sends rice. Somebody sends oil. Somebody is sending groundnuts in the wooden box. Groundnuts in the wooden box. Then amber. Then there is a liquor. Then there is a tank of oil. All these items are now kept in the container. Container is loaded. The container is under transit. What happens sometimes? The container may be loaded in the evening. The cool weather will breeze through the cargo as well as in the container. And the cool weather may be there inside the container. Or they would have cleaned with water. They would not have rubbed it out. And moisture content may be inside. Maybe the wooden boxes may be having moisture contents. Or groundnuts may be having moisture contents. Garlic may be having moisture contents. And oil may leak. What happens when the container move from India or moves to various tropical conditions? Sometimes it will be cool, sometimes it will be hot. During the day, because of the heat, whatever moisture contents there in the product and the packing will start getting dissipated. Now, the vapor inside the container gets cooled in the night and starts refalling. The garlic smell with the vapor fall back on rice. It may fall back on the rice. Then leakage of oil may go to this thing. Then wooden box may dissipate. That may fall on saris, discoloration. So all kind of a damages can happen. There will be a taint damage in case of oil getting the smell of garlic. There can be a contamination. There can be contamination because the wooden water may fall on consumable, that can affect. Then there may be a condensation on vegetables or other items eatable because of the water. What they say, the water which has now fallen on the items because of the moisture is known as sweat damage. Known as sweat damage. This can be condensation if they fall under iron items. So all these items are also covered over and above, and automatically are with a minor premium. They are all very important. There may be questions on types of like time damage, water damage, knee damage, and sweat damage. So I wish you all the best.